Okay, next up, I'm going to do my vegetarian main course, which is going to be like pumpkin polenta wedges. So we're going to start with the pumpkin. Got an iron bark pumpkin here. You could equally use a butternut squash or sweet potato. Probably any veg that you could puree, you know, courgette might work out quite nice, but it's not really the season for them. Don't think you really want to try it with marrows. Well, that might be the first time that you could actually use a marrow for something other than just the biggest vegetable competition down at the village hall, I guess. So, got a piece there, probably about 250 grams. And how am I going to prep it? Going to cut small dice. Sweat it down and then add some polenta to it, cook it out, add some gorgonzola. I would add Stilton, but I'm having real trouble finding that in France at the moment, unfortunately. So cheese, pumpkin, polenta, and then fried to serve with some, you know, roast potatoes, greens, olive oil, probably a bit of lemon dressing. Should be nice. Okay, so that's there. All around about centimetre dice. And that can go into our pan. Give that a really generous season. Salt and pepper. Put a lid on it. If you've got a lid. Let that sweat. And we'll come back when that's cooked. And add the polenta and cheese. Okay, so I think that's probably been cooking for about 6 or 7 minutes. And it's all, like, it's nice, it's soft, but not mushy. So what I'm gonna do, got a pack of polenta, like the instant stuff. Just gonna add probably half of that, I reckon. Which I think is, 75 grams or something, I don't know what the sachet weighs. Half of the sachet you can buy in the shops. Then stir that around. And I'm just going to add water from the kettle. You, of course, could use vegetarian stock or vegetable stock. I don't think I've got any. A bit more. And what you're looking for is a kind of, what's the word? A stiff rice pudding kind of consistency, I guess? I don't know. You'll see when I get there anyway. You want to keep on stirring so it doesn't catch on the bottom of the pan. There you go. This is the kind of thing I mean. I'm going to cook that out. Take it off the heat. Add the cheese. Leave it to set. And then come back and fry it later. Okay, so we've got that, I've cooked it out. So it's quite, kind of like dropping consistency for a cake batter, okay? To that, I'm gonna add some gorgonzola cheese. Take that off the residual heat. Which I'm going to cut into kind of rough cubes. Like that. And then beat it in. But I'm not going to worry about it being all nice and smooth because I would quite like it when we fry the final shape if there's still a little bit of oozy, like cheesy nugget kind of thing in the middle. So we'll come back to the board and I've got glass, or you know, any kind of easy for me to say, any kind of container lined with cling film. We're just gonna spoon in our mix. Now, there's so much you could do with this. Like, obviously, if you wanted to keep it dairy free, you don't have to add the cheese. You could add rosemary at the start with cooking. If you wanted to do it not vegetarian, you could have some, you know, lovely bacon or chorizo or something like that running through it. You could put oranges through, you know, orange zest in there. You could put sage in there. What else? Roasted hazelnuts. What else is there? Next Christmas thing. Chestnuts would be brilliant. Okay, so there we go. It's a pretty good fit. I'm just gonna cover that up, pop that in the fridge, wait for it to set up, which, you know, won't be that long. It wants to be cold, so a couple of hours at least. You could obviously speed that up by sticking it in the freezer or anything like that. And we'll finish that in a bit. Okay, it's time to finish up the polenta, which is set up nicely in the fridge. What I'm going to do, just cut a portion off there. Stick that back in the fridge. And then I'm going to cut up one little wedge, and you can see there, still got a little bit of cheese left, which is what I wanted. quite soft actually. Still, we should be able to save that. And then what we need to do to prepare it for frying, we need to get it in a breadcrumb mix. So you need a plate or a bowl of flour. And give that a generous dusting. And then that needs to go into some beaten egg mix. I wish I had like a wide lens camera or something so I could show you. Whenever you pan egg, keep one hand for the dry stuff and keep one hand for the wet stuff. Okay, and once you've gone into the flour, you go into the breadcrumbs. In there that's didn't quite get beaten in. Excuse me. And then from the breadcrumb, go back into the egg mix. And then back into the breadcrumb. And then we've got a pan over here, warming up as ever. Gonna put a little bit of oil in there. Little bit of butter. And then in with our little, well not so little, in this case wedge. Like that. And you just want to colour that on all four sides and probably run it through the oven for about 5 minutes just to get it warm in the centre. And then we'll make a move on to our sauce. Got some toasted chestnuts. So we'll chop these up reasonably finely. And then I've got some parsley. I'm going to chop and then I'm going to go over with both of them so the flavours start to mingle. Sorry, just tending to the wedge. Okay, then a bit of garlic. And we can run that through. And then I've got a little bit of parmesan here as well. So what we're kind of making is like a Christmas pesto, if you like. But you can't get your pesto out and cheese out, that's great. So, there we go. And then we can pop all of that into a bowl. Get a whack of clementine in there, probably about half a clementine in all. And then give it a little pinch of salt. Quite a hefty grind of pepper. And then olive oil, or I've got some virgin, like cold pressed rapeseed oil, because it's going to kind of reinforce the nutty flavour in it. Spoon. Oil. There we go. I like it. Okay. The board a quick wipe down. Then just because I'm only in a bit of a hurry to get out, sorry guys, you can see, nicely toasted on all sides. Just going to use my serrated edge knife to square that off a little bit. You've got crispy outside, you've got cheesy melted bits with nice little pumpkin chunks. Right, let's go. All the way across. Get ourselves a little plate. And this, you could serve as your main course with all the trimmings. And this nice kind of rustic pesto on the side. Mmm, that's good.